Hey everybody, thanks for tuning in to the live stream. This is going to be a demonstration. Jeff Mack and myself, Eric Meek, we're co-teaching this week. Mike Stevens is our teaching assistant. He's here from Toledo to help out. The class that we've been presenting this week has been all about cane and making goblets out of the cane. And Jeff and I have worked a lot with a lot of Venetian masters, and so we're teaching in the Venetian style, working in three-person teams. And a dragon, of course, is a great thing to watch and really requires a lot of close teamwork. And teamwork is what we're focusing on this week in addition to cane. So we hope it's a great live stream. This should take about 45 minutes or so. We're going to be making the bowl and foot out of some zanfirico twisty cane. And there's some examples out here on the table. And maybe we can get a tight shot of those so you can check out the cane that we're using. There are three different pulls that we did this morning in preparation for this piece. So some tones of purple, and we have some hyacinth overlaid over white, and then some bronze overlaid over white. We're not using dural, we're just using straight enamel white. So Jeff's gonna get started making a collar and picking up the cane. We're going to separate the zanfirico cane into two cups, one for the foot, one for the cup, and then proceed from there, making the dragon and assembling the whole thing. So thanks for tuning in, and we're gonna get started. It's really been a great class so far. We started out by pulling just some straight cane and making supio to do mezza-filigranna, to do a nice tight cane twist in simple tumblers and wine glasses. So from there we're progressing on to doing the zanfirico cane today. This is the third day of the class, Wednesday. So we spent 2 days on filigrana. We'll spend today and tomorrow on this twisted zanfirico cane. And then hopefully Friday and Saturday we'll be doing some reticello and more complex cane decoration techniques. Jeff and I are both full-time employees here at the Corning Museum of Glass. It's been a long time since we've taught together, so it's been a real pleasure this week to work with Jeff. And previously, Jeff was working in Toledo, where Mike is from, so they worked together quite a bit. It's really been fun to work with a team. We've spent quite a lot of time together. So we're going to be working mostly on the other bench now. Jeff, you gonna cut the foot off first or the cup? Thank you. Go ahead. So we really just want to prepare the bubbles, the supio, for making the cane, the cup of the foot. So those are just going straight into the garage. That way we have them set to go. And after we're into the momentum of making the piece and making the dragon, it doesn't take too long to get that nice color pattern and just pick them right up out of the garage. Jeff, you want two sheets out for the dragon, or are you all set there?
Yeah, that one in the back.
Okay. No. So there's a question in the class about gathering over these zanfirico bubbles before. No, and these will just be blown out from what they are. So we're not gathering over the zanfirico cane. So I think you know, for you guys, hopefully each bench, you know, we'll pull three different patterns of cane, and we'll get enough cane that everybody can do a pickup this afternoon. And I think this will probably be the way. You know, we would recommend that all of you proceed, is to pick the cane up and separate it into a foot and a cup portion. And then hopefully we'll have some other things that we can show you for making stems this afternoon. Up until now, we just made simple sort of chicken leg or gumbo stems. And today we're going to start making some, in the class, we're going to start making some different kinds of creatures, like the dragon and dolphin and things like that. What you need. and do a thread. I think it was just off. So this is the move. Watch. All right, so Jeff's formed the upper half of the dragon, shaped the body. Now we're going to start adding the details, adding the head first. Some eyes on it. Now add a mouth. Ready? Do anything else from this, Jeff? And we can't forget the tongue, so our dragon's getting a tongue next. wing sign. The sign for wings. Go ahead and throw one out. Okay. Sideburns for the dragon after the burns.
Every good dragon needs sideburns. The Neil Diamond dragon son.
So the dragon's actually going in the garage. Jeff has just asked Mike to pick up the zanfirico setup for the foot. I'm gonna put the dragon in the garage and then bring it back out and attach it to the foot. Behind you, Mike. So we'll get the dragon a safe, warm place here in the garage. We'll get the Supio, the bubble for the foot, teed up here for Mike to pick up now. So we're probably gonna drop the foot onto a gold ball. So Jeff's setting up some more leaf for the gold ball.
Yeah.
that's cold. Had a little bubble in that, so it's a good place to start over. Not a whole lot invested in that one, so. Are you gonna butt this on, Jeff, or drop it? Okay. Hey, you see, can you give me a lawyer? Can you blow? Go ahead and blow real soft, please. More. Stop. Go ahead and blow softly, please. Good, a little more. 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 Harder. Good. That's it, thanks. Good. Okay, so Mike's going to get the punny for the foot. I'm going to get the dragon on a transfer punny to bring him out of the garage. Can you do another sheet of leaf, please? Have you done this much?
Just one?
Yeah, just one. All right, ready? What do you think of the king? So we have a ballotini cane. It's just a five cane twist through the middle. We've got a cage. And then we've got five on each side with a stringer through the middle. So three different types of cane there. Okay, so just putting some legs on the dragon, and then this will go in the garage, and we'll work on doing the cup. So Mike's I'll get the fork, Mike, if you want to pick up the bowl. Doing some adjustments. We want to get the dragon concentric around that center point there that Jeff's looking at and get the foot flat so that when we get this on the cup, we don't have to do a lot of tweaking. So we're gonna do a bowl with a bowlio on the bottom and honey the bowl inside, bring out the dragon on the foot and attach it, and then hopefully just some minor adjustments to get it straight and put it right in the box if everything goes right. Do you guys have any questions so far? Now you know how to make a dragon, so we've got that one down.
on the stem, just to seal the hole.
That's some heat. You know, really, sometimes you have to think about the massive glass as heat. Like, if you're gathering over a bubble, you don't think about the material, you think about where you're putting the heat. I think that's a good example of that. Quickest way to heat something up sometimes is to put glass on it. I do that. Oh, that's just because my lip wrap was crooked. The lip wrap was crooked. Yeah, that was just to straighten it back out. She said, sometimes I've seen you put a wrap around the lip and then trim it, but it's just because I had a fat attachment point there. The setup he did for the dragon body is something that's kind of similar to setting up a seahorse. So a traditional Venetian dolphin and swan, the body setup is somewhat similar. A traditional setup for a Venetian dragon and seahorse is somewhat similar. Sorry? This is definitely a more, it's not the golden era of Venetian glass kind of dragon. You won't see these from the 15th, 16th, and 17th centuries. These are more 19th century, 20th, yeah. Sort of Venetian Renaissance revival inspired by, yeah. So Jeff's reinforcing a nice terminal point on the bottom of the bowl here. This is going to be a low bowl shape. So you'll see right down to the bottom of it. He wants to make sure that's nice down there. You don't want a half inch money for this, do you? All right, so Jeff's gonna open that up. We're gonna get set up to punty it inside, and I'm going to get the dragon in foot on the hook in the garage. I'm gonna get that puntied up to transfer over. So I need to start thinking about getting the dragon over here tipped over, getting the bottoms up so I can get a punty in there and pull this out of the garage on an iron. I know Jeff's making a low bowl, so it's gonna be some time on the bunny here. It'll take him a little bit longer to open this up than if it were just a sort of a traditional chalice shape.
Hey, Gracie. We grabbed Jess' pedal there.
How are you feeling about this one, Jeff?
Pretty good.
Good.
Pretty good. It's a little, there's some thick and thin cane.
Yeah.
So it's a little bumpy ride, but it's going to be right.
So just getting closer to having this opened up, I'm going to get the dragon on the punny. The worst thing that could happen is that he's going to have to wait for me with this piece punching inside. Alright, so now Mike's gonna do the inside punny. Transfer the cup over.
Yep. Let's see. You want another flash or are you ready to go?
So this just should be on the hook here long enough to straighten the foot and to get that glue joint to cool down a little bit. Obviously you want everything to be pretty much set. The inside punny by nature needs to be pretty delicate. So. Cross your fingers. Just like that. Nice job. Thanks for watching, everybody.